Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today. I hope you're all having a great time. We're going to start with an important update today from Starbase Boca Chica. On the 4th of August, an exciting milestone was achieved as SpaceX's Booster 9 successfully conducted a spin prime test, also known as a chill and spin test. This crucial test involved a flight-like chill and spin of the Raptor engine pumps, which took place in preparation for the upcoming static fire. Elon Musk, the visionary CEO of SpaceX, took to Twitter to share his enthusiasm, announcing that they were gearing up for the next Starship flight. He mentioned that this time they had an estimated 50% probability of reaching orbital velocity, but even reaching the stage separation would be considered a significant accomplishment. One notable improvement on Booster 9 was the addition of new vents on its sides, which were specifically designed to purge each of the engine compartments. These vents served as a preventive measure against potential explosions or fires, which had been a serious concern during the initial integrated flight test. Elon Musk highlighted the importance of addressing this issue during the post-launch discussion, signaling the company's dedication to ensuring the safety and success of their missions. The Booster 9 testing process led to temporary road closures at Boca Chica on August 4th, starting at 6 a.m. Central Daylight Time. By 6:40 a.m., the pad had been cleared to proceed with the scheduled activities. Over the next few hours, operations proceeded efficiently, with OLM, onload methane, venting, completed by approximately 8 a.m., followed by cryogenic loading at around 9:43 a.m. At 10:12 a.m., the highly anticipated spin prime test was finally executed, marking a crucial step forward in the pre-launch preparations. Notably, within 2 hours of the successful spin prime test, the second stage cryo loading was completed, further demonstrating the team's proficiency in handling the complex processes. The day's efforts culminated in the reopening of the road around 3:45 p.m., signifying the smooth progress and completion of the necessary tasks. The continued advancements in their Starship program represent a step closer to achieving Elon Musk's ambitious vision of making interplanetary travel a reality. As they strive to improve their launch capabilities, the lessons learned from Booster 9's testing will undoubtedly contribute to future space missions and pave the way for an exciting and innovative era of space exploration. Now, let's delve into some of SpaceX's other exciting ventures. One of the notable missions in NASA's SpaceX Crew-7, set to take off on Friday, August 25th at 3:49 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the launch was postponed due to necessary pad readiness after SpaceX's recent Falcon Heavy mission. However, this adjustment has provided consecutive launch opportunities and avoided any scheduling conflicts with the space station's cargo spacecraft. The Crew-7 mission comprises a diverse team, including NASA astronaut Jasmine Mogbelli, ESA astronaut Andreas Mogensen, JAXA astronaut Satoshi Furukawa, and Roscosmos cosmonaut Konstantin Borisov. Together, they'll launch aboard the reliable SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, riding aboard the Dragon spacecraft. Docking to the International Space Station's Harmony module is scheduled for about 2:45 a.m. on Saturday, August 26th, with additional launch opportunities on August 26th and August 27th if required. Now, let's turn our attention to the ambitious Starship Asteroid mission. Over the next decade, crewed flights will test systems for exploration beyond low Earth orbit. By 2025, new spacecraft will enable crewed missions beyond the Moon and into deep space, including astronauts visiting an asteroid for the first time. By the mid-2030s, the goal is to have humans orbiting Mars and returning safely to Earth, with an eventual landing on Mars. It's a visionary plan initially proposed in 2010, which is now becoming more tangible with the advancements made by SpaceX. For years, the high cost of launching from Earth has limited space exploration efforts. However, SpaceX's revolutionary Starship promises a new era of space utilization, making it feasible to carry substantial payloads to deep space and distant worlds at a fraction of the traditional costs. The Starship Asteroid mission rejuvenates NASA's asteroid exploration goals, as it now becomes feasible to send a crew of three on a 150-day mission to a near-Earth asteroid. These missions hold immense scientific value, providing opportunities for resource prospecting, including water, which could prove invaluable for future extraterrestrial applications. Initially, they align with planetary defense objectives, expanding our knowledge of solar system formation and pushing the boundaries of human exploration. Crewed missions to near-Earth asteroids offer a unique perspective of Earth from afar, and the SpaceX Starship is an ideal vehicle to facilitate such missions. The proposed concept for a piloted NEA mission involves a crew of three departing and returning from a high Earth orbit, HEO, a strategic move to minimize Delta V requirements and reduce radiation exposure for crew safety. Various considerations have been made for the mission's cargo consumables and logistics, especially during the unpressurized operations near the NEA. The spacecraft's projected weight at the asteroid prior to the crew's departure is carefully calculated at 2,500 kilograms. Sustaining the crew throughout the mission requires meticulous planning, with an average rate of 18.5 kilograms per crew member per day for consumables, along with an additional 10% mass allocated for contingencies. To ensure the mission's success, the propulsion systems rely on liquid oxygen and methane propellants, providing specific impulses of 363 seconds and 327 seconds for the main and secondary propulsion systems, respectively. The mission boasts an impressive total delta-v of 7.051 kilometers per second, supplemented by an additional 400 meters per second through RCS maneuvers. With a total initial mass of 1,220,000 kilograms positioned in HEO, this mission serves as a crucial intermediate step before embarking on a two-year Mars mission. In the pursuit of safeguarding Earth from potential cataclysmic collisions with near-Earth objects, NASA's dedicated task force is hard at work, undeterred by the complexities of transport vehicles. Their mission centers around developing a robust plan to avert disaster and protect our planet from impending threats. Through tireless efforts, NASA has meticulously tracked close to 7,000 near-Earth objects, with a staggering 1,111 of them classified as potentially hazardous asteroids due to their significant size. Nonetheless, a unique challenge arises when attempting to land on an asteroid, as they lack a solid surface for conventional landing procedures. Instead, intrepid astronauts would hover near the asteroid and embark on a thrilling spacewalk down to its surface, donning specialized equipment to facilitate their descent. The experience of standing upon an asteroid's surface would be truly surreal, with the sun appearing to move rapidly across the sky and the distant Earth appearing minuscule, accentuating the astronauts' profound sense of awe and wonder. Despite the daunting obstacles and disorienting aspects, the allure of exploring such an ancient and alien world would undoubtedly captivate the adventurous spirit of many astronauts. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.